Okay, so in the current lesson, we want to start working on the skill section, which you can see at the bottom over here. Okay, so it's time to start working on the skills section. So as far as I can see, we got this legend title, then a list over here with some icons with different colors, then some content into it, and what is to be, let's say 1, 2, 3, just some numbers. We'll look into it later on. And what else? Okay, so we got more titles, front end, back end, others, something like looks like buttons, or might be considered maybe tags, whatever. So let's get started. Let's get started with this. Pretty sure if we open this into our component and we right click it and choose new folder, can type skills, then Control A, Control C, hit enter. Now into the skills, I want to create a new file, skills.pvg, and then another one, skills.scss. And what I want to do now is to hook that style in here. So I will click somewhere on the line 5 and then duplicate it using Alt Shift down, and then double click on the connect, this connect over here. That's the one that I'm double clicking. So double click on that, Control D to select the next occurrence, and then Control V as I've copied already the skills word or string. So now styles CSS is hooked into, or at least this skills CSS is hooked into style CSS. So the style is grabbing all the other smaller parts and it's outputting later on. Let's see. So it's outputting this one over here. Style CSS gets converted into style CSS, and this one gets to be displayed in the browser. Cool. Now let's also hook index in index PUG. Let's hook the skills PUG. So Control D on that, Control V. So now what happens is that this skills is hooked into this one using this part over here. Okay, so that's how it works. Index PUG loads multiple other, let's say, bits of files, and then we get our page. Cool, so everything is hooked or connected, but nothing is yet displayed. As we can see, okay, on my mobile right here, there's nothing saying that skill section exists. Well, there is something inside our software, inside our, let's say, project. However, we want also to display something. So let's get back to our code. Okay, so I think I want to go into the about me and basically just grab those two lines over here. And if I am to paste them into skills and save it, then switch back, we can see that we have welcome to my CV at the very bottom. Yeah, welcome to my CV. Well, I don't want to have welcome to my CV, so let's switch back to the code and see what we can do about it. So I want to create into this data folder, I want to create a new file, skills.json. And here I'll create an object and a property named section title. And as a quick reminder, skills will be the value. So as a quick reminder, into connect we got section title as well, and into about me we got section title as well, right? So what I want to do now is go back into the skills, and instead of accessing the data object with the property about me that comes from the name about me, so that about me comes from here, right? Those are two linked. Now I don't want to link the about me, I want to link the skills, right? Now, because skills doesn't contain any hyphen, I can definitely do skills like this. Okay, so now if I am to look on the mobile, you can see now skills instead of about me. However, I can also remove those parts over here and just do data.skills. Skills is a valid naming for a property or a variable in JavaScript. So now we can definitely confirm again that data.skills.section title is what works. Now, let me try something new. Not sure if it will work, but let's do const here. Actually, not const. Var section title. Yeah, let's leave it with var. It might conflict later on. So this section title might conflict later on. So yeah, I was looking into destructuring, but I'm pretty sure I'm looking for trouble. So with that said, let's get back to coding and see what else we can do about this. Okay, so we got some titles. We got legend, we got front end, back end, and others. And we also got something that looks like some text. So I would say let's start working on those titles in the next lesson. In the next lesson, we add the data for the skills section, the data that's responsible for the legend, let's say small component, or anyway, the legend array.